Good evening. I'm sorry, you're too late. The ball is over, but you're welcome to look under the Christmas tree for your gift. That is, if you have an invitation. Do you?
You have to help me. The Rat King, he kidnapped Princess Mary. I'm Albert. I got into the house disguised as a Christmas gift. I found Mary, but the rats attacked us. I couldn't fight them. It was awful. They took Mary. I followed them as far as the garden, but couldn't squeeze between the bars and the gate. Please help us.
I guess they didn't think it was important to decorate the door. Come any closer and you'll be my next snack.
There's Mary! The Rat King saw Princess Mary, and he wanted her for himself. His army attacked her dollhouse, but Mary ran away. She knew she wouldn't be able to hide from the rats for long. Princess Mary wasn't spoiled like some royalty are. Her smile always lifted me right out of my sorrows. The Rat King wanted Mary from the moment he saw her. His curse turned me into a nutcracker. Mary became a doll. We soon came to life as toys, but by then we'd been separated. The only thing that can break the Rat King's curse now is our love.
I'm alive! I'm alive! Oh, thanks for rekindling my fire! But the rats will only blow me out again. Take me with you. I can help. I promise.
Hello.
Thanks for helping me. My name is Fred. My father was a rather famous rat hunter. He defeated whole armies of rats in his day. I'll live up to him someday, but for now, I'm still learning. But I'm happy to help you and the Nutcracker here.
Mm-hmm.
When I was a boy, I loved to spend hours in the library, reading books about brave knights conquering magical worlds. I imagined I was the hero. As a girl, Mary loved to read too. Her favorite stories always had happy endings. One day we reached for the same book on the library shelf. As we chatted, we realized how much we had in common. She called me Prince, and I called her Princess, just like the characters in that book. I didn't know I had a rival in the form of a rat, as nasty as he was portly. He was watching us that day in the library, plotting how he could get Mary for himself. He wasn't a king then, but his obsession with Mary made him more ambitious than the average rodent. I was always there by Mary's side, standing in his way. He might have given up if it weren't for his discovery of a book of magic spells. He used it to create a magic staff and mount an army of rats. They declared him their king. Then he turned me into a nutcracker, and Mary into a doll.
Thank you.
Couldn't protect Merry from the Rat King. I was just a child's toy, no match for an army of rats. The only thing I could do was escape. I knew they were after me, so I kept running. Until I came upon a strange house deep in the forest. A wise old cat appeared out of nowhere and told me this: a curse is only broken with a kiss.
Thank you. Thank you.
Once upon a time, the Rat King was just a lowly lab rat. His master was a genius named Argus, who was tasked by the royal family to discover the formula for the Sorcerer's Stone. He wanted to change ordinary objects into gold. Argus had had great success blurring the lines between science and magic. He took risks, ignoring the fact that the smallest miscalculation could have disastrous consequences. Argus nearly destroyed the city with one of his experiments. The royal family outlawed his work. Argus was exiled from the kingdom, but he didn't give up his research. He was on the verge of a great discovery. Argus was banned from the royal lab, losing access to the kingdom's great scientific resources. He decided to use his lab rat as a spy. Argus thought he was training a harmless little spy. He never imagined the monster he'd created. The rat.
Thank you. Thank you.
At last, Argus had done it. It was worth the dangers and losses he'd suffered. He could turn lead into pure gold. He scoffed at those who dared doubt his genius. But the substance was unstable and very powerful. A drop of the rat was left alone, without the one friend he'd had in the world. He couldn't return to live with ordinary rats. He had a mind and thoughts.
Thank you.
The rat, with a mind of his own, craved power. First a few joined him, and then more came. Soon he had a loyal army under his command. The Rat King's rise to power alerted the royal family. The king called on the famous Pied Piper of Hamelin to draw the mice away from their mad leader. But the king and his piper had underestimated the Rat King. He turned the Pied Piper into a child's toy. It seemed...
King has been defeated. Princess Mary is safe, but the curse must still be broken. Remember, it all started in the Christmas Hall. Hero placed the nutcracker and the doll just before the clock struck midnight. In a sparkle of Christmas magic, the toys disappeared. In their place were Albert and his beloved Mary. Together at last, just like the prince and princess in the stories they loved as children, the two lived happily ever after. You're not too late for the ball after all. The guests are still here, and the party's in full swing. Christmas comes only once a year, and who knows what will happen next time.
This was a great quest. I'm so glad we helped Albert.
Meow!
Help me!
A kind magician set out to undo the damage caused by the snow wolves. He brought together every breed of cat in the kingdom and cast a spell on them. The results were greater than even he could have imagined. His magic had given the cats special powers. These super cats rose up against the snow wolves and banished them from the kingdom. The kingdom was safe for generations under the protection of these fantastic felines. When a cat passed on, its kittens were trained and ready to take its place. The snow wolves were never a problem again.
Did you see that? Nasty old wolves. If you get me out of here, I'll teach you how to use my potions on them.
Don't call me the wolf whacker for nothing. Don't feel too bad for the wolf. I did what I had to do, and it's lucky for you I did. But I used my last arrow saving your life, so please help me find a few more.
Thank you.
Now! You saved my life! I thought I was kitten kibble. I'm small, but I carry a big shield. You can use it if you want.
Those wolves aren't going to know what hit them. Mess with the cat, and you get the claws.
Oh boy, am I glad to see you. I got a little over my head with those wolves. Back in the day, my daddy would have taken all of them. I guess I have a lot to learn.
Good's a barbarian without his club, I ask you. I feel so naked without my weapon. The horns on my hat, they're just for show.
love balls of yarn. I can't resist them, even with those scary wolves out here. Obviously, you understand cats. I'll come with you. Maybe I can help.